Welcome to Onmanorama movie podcast, Start Action Cut. Today, we are discussing the movie Garudan. It's the Malayalam movie directed by Arun Varma. This is his directorial debut, and the movie is written by Mithun Manuel Thomas. And with this, he has proved his mettle as a writer of crime thriller. So the movie is a suspense thriller produced by distinguished Stephen. Suresh Gopi, Biju Menon, and an ensemble cast, including Siddique, Jagadish, Thalaivasal Vijay, Dilish Potan, Abhirami, Divya Pule, Arjun, Nandkumar, among others. And what I found in the movie was the film is gripping from the beginning to the end and giving you so many surprising and exciting moments throughout. Was it the same for you, Princy?
Yes, Padmakumar. I would also use the same word, you know, exciting. You know, for me, I kind of also got this Ayyappan and Koshin vibe because you have two people with conflicting egos on the opposite sides, you know. But let me be clear while I'm at it. I should say that the characters in the Sachi film was so much more nuanced, but still it's interesting to watch the conflict. So Biju Menon and Suresh Gopi are excellent in their roles as Nishant and Harish respectively. They both have their reasons to put up a fight, but only one will prevail. So Garudan, which is co-written by M. Jinesh and Mithun Manuel, is a modern mystery exploring a new ground by pitting a police officer and a criminal against each other in a court of justice. So when I'm telling you, you know, the premise of the story and the storyline, you kind of get it, right? So it has got that kind of gripping element, and it's got this intensity, like you mentioned, right from the start till the end.
Yes, it's gripping just because the way it's written. But what I found was things happen in a huff. Everything happens in a hurry that you hardly get a time, a chance to sit back and nitpick. So there are several questions that arise as you watch the film, but you forget them all as you move on. So that's the way it's written. And I think hats off to Mithun Manuel Thomas for scripting the movie in such a fashion. And the gripping element is all the more brought about by the treatment, by everything that you see in the movie, the ambience, the music, and the tone, and everything that has been brought into the film to produce that thrilling suspense element has been successful. So that has been one of the factors that made the movie interesting. But I wouldn't say that it's totally flawless. There are things that we'll discuss later. But the plot line, as you see, it's again a murder mystery. You see that a young girl has been physically abused and she is in a coma in a hospital. And the investigation that follows is what makes the crux of the story. And here you can see the police officer, DCP Harish Madhav, played by Suresh Gopi. He's in charge of investigating the crime. And we find that he gets all the tips and all the clues towards the crime. And he instantly resolves the mystery. That's how it goes on. And in the beginning itself, you find that the crime, the person behind the crime is nabbed. But I think there are so many questions that are thrown up now and then in the movie, in the story itself, of not doing a cross-check or taking a second opinion and things like that. There are so many such elements that they show in the film itself. But whatever he does is found to be true in the end. So what do you think about that, about the plot line, Princy?
Padmakumar, it did cross my mind, you know, like, you know, how can a police officer not be doing this cross, you know, a second check and all that. But given the kind of experience that the police officer has and the kind of bond and the backing that he has from the lawyer played by Siddique, you kind of think that it's plausible, you know, you kind of have these things overlooked because of all this. But probably that is also, you know, the kind of doubts don't linger for a long time because of the quick pace and fast cut scenes that are prevalent in the movie. You know, the movie does not beat around the bush and quickly arrives at the plot. there are a lot of twists in the movie, the kind of intrigue that they brought in. And definitely the credit does go to the scriptwriter. What I liked is how, you know, Mithun did not do a repeat of an Anjaam Padra here. You know, like when I mentioned that, I should say because that element wasn't there, I felt that the second half was quite underwhelming because of that. But despite all that, you know, how, you know, the filmmaker's vision was evident throughout. You know, it was both, you know, the scriptwriter and the filmmaker, both of them, the director, they both worked together to ensure that the movie moved and progressed in such a way that you don't have enough room for more questions. And that is what I think worked for Garudan.
Yeah, true, Princy. But I would like to disagree with you that there is no element of serial killing in this. So towards the end, pardon me if I am giving the spoiler.
But then I found that a little, you know, too quick, you know, they didn't actually linger on it.
Yeah.
And maybe if they had lingered on it, it would have maybe, you know, given a little more backing to his abrupt ending there, I felt.
No, what I meant was there is an element of a serial killing aspect in this movie too. Because when you unravel his past, you see that there are cases that he had been part of earlier. I mean, the character played by Biju Menon. So that's there. But anyway, it's not an exact copy of Anjaam Padra, that I would agree. But here, what I think is, this is a brilliant script. And then there are some naiveties of a debutant director here and there. There are so many elements that look very immature here and there. But when coming to the performance of the actors, I think the performance of the actors was a big factor in this movie of elevating its suspense aura. Like coming to Suresh Gopi as DCP Harish, I think he initially had that gaudy attitude, which was very immature and melodramatic in stylizing that character. He's been mimicked for that gaudy or stylish and pompous gestures. And he has repeated the same thing here. I don't know whether he liked it, the filmmakers, you know, was attempting to portray or exhibit that the character was like that. I don't know. But later, as the film progresses, he shows that kind of maturity in him. But what I found was Biju Menon's character so convincing and so matured, so perfect throughout the movie. But there are certain scenes, in the crucial moment of transformation, the transformation scene where both of them are in a conversation across the table, you can see, confronting each other. That scene, you can see that Biju Menon's transformation from his adamant denial of the facts that DCP was putting across. Finally, he had no escape and he had to accept, or he has to reveal his true essence. So at that moment, those few minutes were, I think, very immature, very, very shaky. That should have had that maturity, that intensity, but that was missing. And I don't know, Biju Menon might have done that maybe after a few more takes or something like that. But here, what we see, what I felt was this. And also, Jagadish as Salam was very convincing. And nowadays, I think he has got back his mojo. And he has been executing that brilliant prowess of performing character to the zenith of its essence. So what do you think about the performance of the actors?
Padmakumar, when you mention about that moment, you know, when they're confronting each other, and that particular moment where Biju Menon's character does agree with the things that he's done and things, I think, Padmakumar, when this particular moment where both the characters are confronting each other in that room, I think it is not the performance of the actor that was an issue there. The performance of Biju Menon as an actor, that he showed immaturity there. I felt that the script itself is not developed in that particular point. It felt like the writers were in a hurry to find a solution, to come to a conclusion, to come to a climax. I would rather say that it was a script that needed to be developed over there. And in terms of acting, definitely, Biju Menon was one of the key highlights of the film. He goes on to show the kind of nuanced actor he is and how he can perform many roles. He's played serious and villain characters in the start of his career and then shifted to comedy in the previous decade. I would definitely love to see him back in comedy. But said that, you know, he delivers the layered performances in serious roles like the one he did in Ayyappan and Koshi and all that. So I believe he's an underrated actor. And also in terms of Jagadish, like you mentioned, you know, he's found his spot and he was at the zenith, you know. So the kind of mannerism that he portrayed in Garudan was kind of similar to the one in Kapa, where he plays the confidant of Prithviraj's character. So he's delivered such an intense performance, and it's really nice to see him in this kind of position in his career. And Abhirami too deserves a word of mention because she has performed really well over here and has definitely played a seasoned actor in this movie. And Siddique, definitely we do not have to go there because he is always and often proved himself to be really good in playing side characters. And Suresh Gopi impresses, but there is a fire missing from this commissioner actor. You know, his voice modulation has changed ever since his comeback to films with even Main Hoon Moosa and Papan also, where the kind of earlier fire in him is missing. So yeah, that's what I think about the performances in the movies. And also word of mention to all the new actors who's played minor roles and mostly minor roles in the film.
Yeah. As you mentioned, if the confrontation scene went bland just because of the poor writing, I think it's a major flaw in the whole thing because that is the crucial moment of the film. I mean, the height of the film. But then there are so many thrilling moments in the film too. I mean, the disappearance of the girl itself, and then towards the final scenes when the girl is pulled to the side of the building, and also the character of Teresa Philp, played by Chaitanya Prakash, and her support system was disrupted all of a sudden. That moments were also very, very gripping. But at the same time, there are certain questions. I think in foreign films, they wouldn't make such a mistake. Like the prowess, the power of the criminal who dragged the girl to that place within such a short span of time. So that was never shown even once. So at least they could have shown how he executes his crime. That would have made the film all the more thrilling. So do you find any flaws in the movie? What are the flaws that you would like to highlight, Princy?
I think what you mentioned, you know, the way how he is actually executed the crime, I think the makers show that in terms of, you know, flashbacks, not this particular victim, but, you know, how this villain had actually been with the rest of the other victims of his. So, but then it would have, you know, brought in more authenticity to show how this particular victim was also handled. Another thing that I felt was when it comes to Suresh Gopi's character, I think when you're pitting two people, you know, you have doubts about both of them, right? One person has done a short, you know, kind of not a shoddy job, but, you know, there was kind of a flaw from his side and the other person is an accused. And you're pitting these two people against each other. But then one will definitely be the culprit. So being Suresh Gopi, you know, Suresh Gopi towards the later half of his career has not done any villain roles, has not played villain roles. So it kind of, you kind of know then and there, you know, who's going to be the villain. Despite all the twists and all the intrigue that is brought in, you kind of have this predictability factor. And that is one thing, and maybe if it was another actor other than Suresh Gopi there, probably, you know, we would have that suspense till the end. And yeah, that is one thing. And also, like I mentioned earlier, the underwhelming climax kind of affected the full viewing experience of the movie for me.
Yeah, surprisingly, what you said is right, Princy, that if the protagonist was anyone else, even if it was Mammootty, things could have been different. I mean, he could have been the villain. So this predictability is another factor that is there throughout the movie. Yet, I think it's a gripping the way the sequences flow and the treatment is given. I think it's a very gripping and engrossing film to watch. So that brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Start Action Cut, produced and hosted by me, Padmakumar, with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for more podcasts on movies, and be sure to come back for the next episode of Start Action Cut, out on Mondays. Thank you.